In the beginning, we drew them, as they watched from afar. When we met them, we were mesmerized. We were new beings, and their knowledge amazed us. They showed us construction techniques and helped us build cities. We were unaware they were doing this to get man concentrated, so we would be easier to control. This was done throughout the Earth. They placed half-blood kings in power to be their proxies. They gave us knowledge, so we would fight and destroy each other. Exiled taught men how to make slaughtering knives, arms, shields, and coats of mail. He showed them metals and how to work them. Shemhazai instructed them in exorcisms and how to cut roots. Armaros taught them how to raise spells. Barakal, divination from the stars. Korkabel, astrology. Kazdiyai showed the sons of men all the evil blows of the spirits and of the demons, and the blows that attack the embryo in the womb so that it miscarries, and the blows that attack the soul. Yadril showed all the deadly blows to the sons of men, and he led astray Eve, and he showed the weapons of death to the children of men, the shield and the breastplate, and the sword for slaughter, and all the weapons of death to the sons of men. And we built temples to worship and give gifts of blood to our gods of many names. As the centuries passed, the gods started to get nervous, because they underestimated the descendants of Adam. You see, an individual man is not immortal, but the knowledge and experience passed from one son to another is. For every element and craft we mastered, a minor god was debilitated and stripped of their mantle. Eventually, we grew strong enough to dispatch the half-blood kings and replace them with man. Thousands of years passed until the day we stripped a major god of his mantle. This was the day the descendants of Adam became the god of war.
He knew the world would not be the same. Few people laughed. Few people cried. Most people were silent. I remembered the line from the Hindu scripture, the Bhagavad Gita. Vishnu is trying to persuade the prince that he should do his duty, and to impress him, takes on his multi-armed form and says, "Now I am become death, the destroyer of worlds." I suppose we all thought that one way or another.
Since then, our power has grown exponentially, debilitating the major gods one by one. You see, we, the descendants of Adam, have found a new god to worship, ourselves. We will burn the pantheon to the ground and turn the old gods to ash. And how does this whole story end? The same way it started.